do you think are to blame for the riots? And do you think they could be prevented? And what would you have done differently if you were in power?
Well, it's a really good question, Neil. I mean, look, like you, I was raised in a council estate.
All right.
My dad would drive a bus for 56 hours a week. My mum would raise the kids at home, and to make ends meet would make clothes. The obvious question to ask is, how is it you and me, who come from that sort of background, aren't smashing up shops and rioting and doing bad things? And so it's really easy to say the riots are caused because, you know, young people have got no idea of law and order, or because there's a feral underclass, or because it was too hot, or because there were cuts in education maintenance allowance, or because, you know, there were cuts in tuition fees. That's just too easy. And it's too simple. You and I know that's not what happened. So I think one of the things we need to do is understand what's happening. I think there's a culture developed now where it's a something for nothing culture, where whether you're in a boardroom or an MP claiming expenses or somebody claiming benefits or a young person on a street seeing somebody walk away with a 20-inch plasma screen, you think you can get something for nothing. And so I think it's a bit too lazy and easy to blame it on one thing. I'm not sure, if I'm honest, what the causes of the riots were. What I do know is I meet every day young people who, you know, come from deprived backgrounds, don't smash up windows, don't do bad things, and I think we've got to be careful about the language we use, not to demonise and give all young people a bad name.